Okay, so 10th standard students, a very warm welcome and good morning to all the students of 10th standard students of JC English High School. So as of now, we are going through the geography part, and in the geography part, last video we have completed the soils, India soils, the soils of India, what it is, how many types are there, how to do the soil conservation, soil erosion, what are the effects, causes, everything we have completed. Okay, so and even the exercise part also has been sent to you. Now today we will be starting with a fresh chapter, that is India forest resources. Forest means the place where we can see an extensive place of trees, means a big area with trees and wild animals are there, that is their home also. So what is this forest? We should go through this past. A large area of land covered with trees is called forest. A large area of land covered with trees is called forest. They are natural. It is generally extensive. Extensive means huge, vast area. It's not that only this much, whatever your school is there like that. It is a vast area. Okay. And commercial value. Commercial values are there. Trees are very much expensive. It consists of either natural or planted vegetation. Natural vegetation. Forests are the place where the trees grows naturally. Nobody plant. Yes, even some places are there which we make for the biodiversity. We make it a planted vegetation. Means we plant trees there to make a forest. Forest is one of the natural resources of India. Okay, we all know this is a natural resources. Okay, so like air, water, okay, the trees what we are having in the forest, that is also a natural resources of India. They provide a large variety of wood. From trees we are getting wood which are used as fuel. Okay, timber is used for making furniture and industrial raw material. In the industry, raw material, the wood is also used. They provide fodder for livestock and employment opportunity for the people. Okay, what is this fodder? It is there in the keywords. Okay, fodder means food. Okay, fodder means food for the farming animal. Okay, they gives farming animals are there. This grass and all they used to take. Okay, they provide fodder for livestock. Livestock means farm animal. Okay, and employment opportunity for the people. People, see, forest is there. One department is there, forest department. There people have to work there. They take the management and they maintain the forest. So people are getting employment from that. Forest preserves the physical features. Forest preserves the physical features. If anybody is asking you what is the physical features of India, the forest will come as a point, one point. Okay. Prevent soil erosion, destruction of soil. Okay. Control floods and regulate the flow of river. Regulate the flow of river also. If forest is there, in between the forest, if place is there, the river will flow. Make the climate equable. That is the main thing. Forest is there means they will take our carbon dioxide and they will give us oxygen. So, our equability in the atmosphere will be there. So, climate is equable and help to maintain ecological balance. If we are giving, see, already we are heavy as per the populations. Now, this much of populations and if trees are not there, from where we will get oxygen, which is the basic thing we need to be alive. Now we will go, they provide shelter to wildlife. Wildlife, they will be taking shelter in forest only. Forest is the home for all the wildlife. Okay, whatever it is, tiger, lion, whatever, rabbit, okay, elephant, anything, any wild animal, the forest is the home or house for them. Okay, that is the they provide shelter to them. Now we will go for the types of forest. The types of forest depends on climate, soil and relief. Okay, so what are the three things it depends? The types of forest, it depends on climate, soil and relief. Of this, climate is the most important factor. They can be classified into six main types. What are they? The tropical evergreen forest, the tropical deciduous forest, the scrub forest and desert land, the desert vegetation, the mountain forest and the mangrove forest. So these are the six types of forest we are having in India. So what are they? The tropical deciduous, the tropical evergreen forest, the tropical deciduous forest, the scrub forest and desert land, the desert vegetation, mountain forest and mangrove forest. So first we will go through the in detail we will go through this one. The tropical evergreen forest, this is known as evergreen. The word evergreen we used, okay, why this is this forest is called evergreen, we will get to know from the notes. This type of forest are found in areas where rainfall is more than 250 centimeter annually. It is only possible, evergreen forest are seen in those places where rainfall is high and the temperature is high. Okay, so the place with the rainfall more than 250 centimeter annually, in that place only we will get the evergreen forest. These forests are long and dense due to heavy rain and high temperature. These forest trees are long, okay, in height, and they are also dense, means one by one it is there, okay. Rain, even there are some evergreen forests where the sunlight doesn't come to the earth, means down soil, okay. These are found mainly on the western slopes of the Western Ghat, and hills of northeastern states of Assam, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipur and Andaman and Nicobar Island. So where these are found? These are found mainly on the western slopes of the Western Ghat and hills of northeastern states of Assam, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipur and Andaman and Nicobar Island. These trees, the trees of this forest do not shed their leaves. Shed means it doesn't fall down, okay. Doesn't shed their leaves during the year. All other forests, if you go, you can see after the winter, before the summer, means the spring season is there, no? So in that season, they shed their leaves, but these evergreen trees, they don't shed their leaves. The trees of this forest do not shed their leaves during the year at the same time. So they are called evergreen. Throughout the year, the leaf will be there. They don't shed their leaves. That's why they are known as evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest. The tropical deciduous forest. That is the next one. Okay. Second one is the tropical deciduous forest. What is this tropical deciduous forest? These forests are found in areas with an annual rainfall of 100 to 200 centimeter. There it is for evergreen, it is 250 centimeter annually. Here it is 100 to 200 centimeter annually rainfall. The trees in this forest shed their leaves after winter and again reappears during spring or early summer. Hence they are also known as monsoon forest. This deciduous forest is also known as monsoon forest. Why? After the winter, before the summer, a period is there when it is not so much hot, not so much cold. That is known as spring season. During this season, the trees of this plant, they shed, means the leaf fall down. Okay, that's why it is known as monsoon forest also. They are found largely on the eastern slopes of the Western Ghat. Tropical evergreen forests are found in the western slopes of the Western Ghat. And these are found in the eastern slopes of the Western Ghat, including Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. Also in Chota Nagpur Plateau, foothills of Himalaya. Foothills of Himalaya means the down of the Himalaya. Parts of Odisha and West Bengal. Okay, these are the place where you can found this type of deciduous forest. What are the trees which are present in deciduous forest? Trees like teak, shal, sandalwood. Okay. Teak, shal, sandalwood, kusum, kanju. Okay. Myrobalan, ceres. Then mango, neem, tamarind, etc. are found in this type of forest. So what are the type of trees found in this one? Tropical deciduous forest. They are teak, shal, sandalwood, kusum, kanju, myrobalan, ceres, mango, neem, tamarind, etc. At least three names you have to memorize. Name three trees found in deciduous forest. And what are the trees found in evergreen forest? They are teak, rosewood, ebony, mahogany, gurjan, champa, etc. are found in this type of forest. Means these are the trees found in evergreen forest. And this neem, mango, tamarind, ceres, myrobalan. Okay, these are the trees found in deciduous forest. In the next video, we will be discussing about the scrub forest and desert land, desert vegetation, mountain forest and mangrove forest. These are small. Main is these two. Questions are also coming from main these two. Why? What is the other name of deciduous forest? Okay, monsoon forest, like that. Why it is evergreen forest? Because they don't shed their leaves during the time of between winter and summer. Okay, these are the things you have to remember. You should have the concept. That's all, nothing else. Okay, thank you and see you in the next video.